Hello, fellow gamers. Crypto Panther back, bringing you some Rhyme. Game just released this past week on Friday. I finally got my copy in the mail today, on Monday. Whether this is, you're watching this probably on Tuesday, maybe. So I just put the game in. I haven't done anything else except watch a little bit of the company propaganda at the start, and the logos and etc. Now with this lovely blue header space looking screen with an X. So, we press X. And the game starts. Graybox presents. Game by Tequila Works. So this is like a 3D puzzle platformer type game. There's my character. Or there's me, I guess. The character I play. Time to get up. I remember seeing this game at E3, not last year, the year before? I don't know, it was even the year before that. And I was like, oh, this game looks cool. It's like kind of like a Journey-esque, you know, type of game. There's lots of similar games out there. They're just, you know, run around kind of puzzle type, you know, I don't really call them platformers or roll, jump, yell. This is, it's just, you know, teabag. I guess touchpad or triangle does that. Alright. Figuring out the controls. It looks pretty cool. Like I said, from a little bit that I've seen, and, oh, cool, you're swimming. Oh, you even swim underwater. Interesting. Very cool. I don't know how far I can swim. I swim to the middle of the ocean. I'm gonna guess there's probably an invisible wall up here. Or the game's gonna make. Yeah, there it is. I didn't think you'd be able to swim to the ocean. Very cool. Yeah, so I was saying, I've been seeing this game at E3 like 2 years ago. And originally it was supposed to be PlayStation exclusive. I don't know if there was, but the deal fell through, but what happened was the company ended up buying the rights to the game back from Sony, and they went ahead and continued developing it, you know, under their own, you know, their own banner, whatever you call it, no tie into the console, and so they released it for the PS4, which I'm playing this on. This is on the PS4. Can you get up there, buddy? I know it's out for, I do believe it is out for Xbox and also even the Switch, apparently. So, gone from being an exclusive to Sony to being a multi-console platform game. I don't think it's on PC. But if someone does know that, they can always check the comment down below and let me know. Hey! Oh, what's that up there? Holy shit! He yells at shit and breaks box. I guess only the ones that have the goddamn lizard on the wall. Oh shit. I'm gonna fall to my death. I don't know what kind of falls look like I can take, if any at all. Pull yourself up there, boy. So that's the beach I just come from. Oh shit! Don't fall down. I don't need to break a leg. Up there? Nope, can't go up there. Hey! What do I do to activate this? Sit on it. I don't care what I'm supposed to do with that. What am I supposed to do with this thing? It's like, hey, there's something, but you can't interact with it. Okay. I gotcha. Kinda runs funny. Jump. So I just basically went around in a circle. Well, that's productive. I don't see a spot to climb up anywhere. So I'm guessing anywhere I can climb up has that little bit of the white ledge on it. Can I get over there somehow? I'm curious what the hell this is. It's like a shell or something. I don't have... Ow! Okay. Okay, so I guess I have to click more of those conch shells, I guess they are. Oh, can I jump off into the water? I just want to try it, but I figure I'm going to kill him. I'm going to go for it. Oh, sweet, I survived. Well, I don't want to go back that way just yet. I want to keep kind of exploring this way. In case I missed something. Farther than here. Yeah, invisible wall. Yeah, as far as I can go, I can't get over there. There's that one ledge to climb up and it takes me back around, so I guess I come down and go this way. I'll get your jaunt on there, little fella. I know there is a companion in this game. I think it's a little fox. You hang it with us. I'm scared of seagulls. Keeps adjusting his sandals. Oh shit, I'm gonna drown? It's awful dark down here. Watch out, the poor little fella. And that's as far as I can go here. Alright. So I take it I have to push forward. Difficult to find save points. I'm not sure what categorizes or counts as a save point in this game. It's basically get no real introduction to anything. The game just starts and you start playing. I guess it kind of tutorials. I mean, this is tutorial level. I think that's your. Where you're trying to get to. Oh, there's a save point right there. Up in the upper right corner. So what I'll do, I'm going to probably keep these episodes a little short. I don't need to get into big, long 20, 30 minute episodes. Unless I run into some long puzzles and stuff, these episodes could get longer. But what I'll do is the first intro video, I guess, to this is a little over 13 minutes, I guess, roughly. Isn't too bad. Yeah, we're investigating that blue light in the sky or to the ground in the next episode. So as always, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and we'll see you next time. What the fuck is that over there?